Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening. My name is Dale McKay. I'm a senior technical marketing architect in the Network and Advanced Security Business Group here at VMware. Over the next few minutes, I'd like to take you through some integration that we have put in place that integrates the SaltStack capabilities with our Carbon Black Cloud workload product. So in this video, I'm going to walk you through all of the steps that you need to implement to be able to get your SaltStack conversing with the Carbon Black Cloud. Let's spend just a few minutes talking about how we integrate SaltStack with Carbon Black Cloud. The SaltStack appliance is an appliance that's going to run on top of CentOS. You can see right here that it's running on top of CentOS 7, 64-bit. And there's an install guide that's going to walk you through the step-by-step process of getting it installed and up and functioning to the point where I am now, where it's connected, it's up and running, and it is accessible via the web. And you can see that I have a DNS name in here for SaltStack. Once I get to that point, one of the first things I want to do is I want to come in here, and there will be a master key underneath pending, and I want to accept that key. You can see in my particular case, I've already accepted that key. One of the next things that we're going to want to do is go and configure underneath connectors, underneath settings, and there's that connector. So I'll need the URL for my particular organization's Carbon Black Cloud console. I'll also need this token. I'll talk more about that in just a minute. And I'll need the org key. And then, of course, we want to verify that SSL is correctly configured. Now, in order to get all of this information, that means you're going to have to go into the Carbon Black Cloud console. We have already done that, and we have created an access level called SALT, and let's take a look at what that access level entails. It's actually very simple. There's a read for general device information. There's a read and execute for vulnerability assessment data. And you can see those are all the permissions that are included in the SALT access level. Now, once I've completed that, I can go to the API keys and add that API key, use that SALT access level, and it will generate API credentials. This app ID and this app secret key. These are two pieces of information that I need to come over here and add in to this line. It's going to want the secret key first, as opposed to what it says here. It's going to want the secret key first and the org key. And you can find those right here, secret key and the org key. This org key that you see here, in fact, I'll even show you mine, is this org key right here. All right, so you've accepted the master key. You have made your connection into the Carbon Black Cloud, and you should see something that looks like that. You should be able to, again, go and see those API credentials. And then if we come back over to SaltStack, probably one of the next things that we want to do is we want to deploy SaltStack to one of the devices that we're going to manage. Now, this is called a minion, and we're going to use one of the Windows 10 platforms that I have in my lab. I've already downloaded the installer, the MSI, for SALT. It's right here. We're going to install SALT on this particular Windows 10 box. In order to do that, I need to open an elevated command prompt and then execute. If you try to install the MSI just by double-clicking on a desktop, you're going to get an error message that directs you to open or to install it with an elevated privilege level. So just that's where you want to go through that install process using a elevated privilege level through either a command prompt or, as you saw me do, through a PowerShell prompt. And now the install has completed. We can move back over to our SaltStack platform. We will see that we have a minion key that is now pending. I can accept that key. And at this point, that minion is now part of my minion inventory, if you will. You can see it right here. If you want to see it connected and have some of this other information filled out, there's a job that you can run that will actually go out and ping those minions. It's called test ping. You can just run that now. And in just a minute, it's going to come back as connected, and it will have that information filled out. At this point, we have connected our SaltStack platform to the Carbon Black Cloud platform. So that's the basic steps for getting the integration and getting your inventory of minions developed, available for a wide variety of operating systems.